We want to show that 0.3 repeating equals 1/3. Recall another way to express 0.3 repeating is 0.3 with a bar over the 3. We begin by writing 0.3 repeating as an infinite sum. 0.3 repeating equals 0.3 plus 0.03 plus 0.003 and so on. Next, we'll factor 3 from the right side of the equation, which gives us 3 times the sum of 0.1, 0.01, 0.001, and so on. Next, we'll write the decimals as fractions. 0.1 is equal to 1/10, 0.01 is 1/100, 0.001 is 1/1000th, and so on. Next, we'll write the fractions as powers of 1/10. Of course, 1/10 is equal to 1/10, 1/100th is the square of 1/10, 1/1000th is the cube of 1/10, and 1/10,000th is equal to the fourth power of 1/10. From here, we can write the right side using sigma notation, where we have the sum from k equals 1 to infinity of 3 times 1/10 raised to the power of k. In this form, we should be able to recognize the repeating decimal is a sum of a geometric sequence or a geometric series. And if we want to, we can change the base of 1/10 to the decimal of 0.1. So again, 0.3 repeating is a sum of a geometric sequence, or we can say a geometric series. So because we have a sum of a geometric sequence, we will now determine the sum using the method of multiply, shift, and subtract. To do this, we write the sum as an equation, and then we form another equation by multiplying the first equation by the common ratio. We shift over the products on the right to get the subtraction to mostly cancel out. We subtract the two equations and then solve for s. So again, first we have s equals the repeating decimal as a sum, which is 0.3 plus 0.03 plus 0.003 and so on. And then to form the second equation, we multiply the first equation by the common ratio of 0.1 or 1/10, and then we subtract. First multiplying, 0.1 times s gives us the 0.1s, and then on the right, 0.1 times 0.3 gives us the 0.03. Notice how this is shifted right, so this lined up directly below the 0.03 in the first equation. The second product is 0.1 times 0.03, which is the 0.003, and the pattern continues. And now we subtract the second equation from the first equation. On the left, s minus 0.1s is 0.9s. On the right, notice all the terms will simplify out except the first term in the first equation, which is 0.3. All the other terms do simplify out. 0.03 minus itself is 0, 0.003 minus itself is 0, and so on. Now to solve for s, we divide both sides of the equation by 0.9, which gives us s equals 1/3. And this does show 0.3 repeating is equal to 1/3. I hope you found this helpful.